Hi, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and it's morning time, and we've had a cold snap, so it's just a little, it's right around freezing, 32 degrees Fahrenheit, and that is the time that sparks the ginkgo tree that we have had now for years to drop all its leaves. It started yesterday when it was chilly, and today it's going to be pretty much done. These leaves have all fallen between yesterday and today. We have our bushes now that are covered with the ginkgo leaves. They look like they're ginkgo bushes. Oop, here they go. Any little hint of a breeze and the rest of them will be down. So they go from one day being green and then suddenly they turn golden and then they fall. Ginkgos are one of the ancient trees from China, and they have this very special fan shape to them. None of the leaves seem to be the same. They all have their own little crevices, but they're all fan-shaped.
Kind of like a snowflake.
Mm-hmm. Some of them are very deeply cut, and others hardly at all. But they are just so cool. And usually our grandson loves to come over and we rake him in a big pile and he jumps into the pile because it's just amazing to see them when they fall because they'll just be down in 1 or 2 days. Yeah. So we thought you would like to see how they just miraculously know when it's time to leave.
Is that a play on words? Know magically when to leave?
It could be.
Oh, okay. Well, this is quite a pile of leaves that dropped this morning.
Yes. And we could hear them hitting against the bedroom window. That's a neat one right there with the sun shining right through it. As you can see on the garage roof, everybody's roof has a little layer of frost where the sun has not yet struck.
And that's that frost.
The trigger.
That's the frost that triggers this snowfall of leaves. It is amazing.
Golden and green leaves. Right now, there's another ginkgo across the street from ours that still has most of its leaves. So it'll be interesting because obviously this microclimate here triggered before the one across the street. Each has their own time.
Now, some ginkgos have medicinal purposes.
Right. You've all heard of the ginkgo biloba, I think it's called. I don't know if that's what this one is. I've never actually chewed on any of its leaves.
So we could chew on these leaves?
Well, you can try it.
Hmm.
All I know is that it's such a fascinating tree. It's so beautiful that it gives us the aesthetic quality of its beauty.
Well, think of the years we went looking for one.
Yes.
And yes, we finally found one probably about 10 years into our search because a lot of the local nurseries didn't carry them.
Right.
I was going to say grocery stores.
They are very slow growing. I found a picture of this one in one of our photograph books, and it looked like a little twig.
Well, you said it was just a little taller than you.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's probably, what, about 45 feet?
It's been here a while.
And that base of the tree, the width of the tree, is a good, I'd say, 12 inches at least. Well, down at the bottom.
Right.
Down at the base of the tree. It has this really nice texture to it, and it is such a hardwood because it is such a slow growing.
Yes,
I remember one winter, we cut little branches off and we took them to school and had the kids make pencils.
Mm-hmm. Yep, very cool. Bye for now. Enjoy your day.
Hey, I didn't get my breakfast yet. Could nibble on some leaves, I suppose. I got really hungry.
No, I'm going to go in and drink a coffee.
Oh, okay. Fall in Wisconsin.